Day in your country and elsewhere in the ASEAN economies. Finally, folks, I want to show you something. Take a look at this little doozy here. Cute, isn't it? Huh? Make me look like a cyborg or something out of Star Trek. Meet the new Jabra JX10 Kara Bluetooth headset. What? You know, we're talking not just mobile handsets, but headsets. I'll bet you didn't know. A little bit of trivia here. It's a $2.5 billion industry, and it's growing close to 20% a year. GN is the world's largest maker of mobile headsets. I'll bet you didn't know that. You know that Nokia, Motorola, LG makes phones, but did you know that GN is the biggest maker of headsets like this? It's a company based in Copenhagen, Denmark. Earnings up 35% in the first quarter. We're joined this morning by Senior Vice President for the Asia Pac of GN Netcom, Christian Tang-Jespersen. Welcome to the show.
Thank you very much.
First question, this is the gold one, right?
Correct.
$350?
Yep.
I don't even spend one third of that on a phone.
Well, basically, there's a number of phones where you would spend a lot more than this. So basically, this is just reflecting a trend mm-hmm. in the general market where people are asking for differentiators mm-hmm. in general.
Uh-huh. And there's another version there, right, that you have in your hand? That's
yes.
The stainless steel.
This is stainless steel, a little bit less flashy, if you like,
uh-huh.
A little bit more in trend with the Scandinavian cool look.
Right. How come nobody knows, maybe I'm insulting you here. How come nobody knows who GN is? Do you prefer to make them kind of quietly and then whoever brand them or what?
Well, we've only been around for 150 years, so it could maybe be their fault.
Obviously, you haven't even gotten started yet.
Exactly. So, no, I think what we're known for is our brand Jabra.
Uh-huh.
GN is our company name, and we're not spending a lot of time promoting that. Mm-hmm. We are focusing on one brand.
I guess you don't really need to, right, if you're number one in the world.
It works easier being number one in the
uh-huh.
world. That's
do you only
for sure.
do it? Do you only do branded ones under Jabra, or do you do it on an OEM basis?
We do OEM as well
for everybody.
For everybody
uh-huh.
and their friends.
Why is the market growing like it is? You're looking at 17% annualized growth. What are people just? Are people talking so much? Do they have so much to say that they can't be bothered to actually hold that phone up next to their face, or are they getting fatter and they can't get the earpiece and the mouthpiece in one?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I'm getting fatter. No, unfortunately, I think what we are seeing is just a reflection of the communication exploding.
Uh-huh.
And a Bluetooth is a very Bluetooth headset is a very neat way of being more effective. It's also in a number of countries a legal requirement if you drive. So there's a number of reasons why you would wear a headset, also for convenience.
Uh-huh. What is it? Does it just let me talk, or can I do other things? Can it play the ocean sounds and kind of soothe me as I go to sleep?
Well, in theory, it could. If you're using a Bluetooth stereo, it could play your favorite tunes, your music. But it also talk. You can also control the phone by demanding for it to call someone and so forth.
But most of us only have two ears, or one at
yes.
best sometimes. And more often than not, it's got an iPod stuck in them.
Yeah.
So it's going to be it's an either-or kind of thing.
No, not really.
Are you competing against Apple?
Not at all. Not at all. No. Apple is actually helping a lot the Bluetooth stereo part of it. So you have enablers put into your Apple, and then you have wireless music,
uh-huh.
and then on top of that, you don't lose your phone call
uh-huh.
because the Bluetooth will tell you when the phone calls us at the
wow,
same time.
Wow! Look at all those specs there. It's less than 10 grams, one third of an ounce, less than 4 centimeters. Why don't you actually do something with Apple, or you know? Instead of just a Bluetooth, instead of just talking and hooking up to your mobile phone, you could actually play music. At the same time, you could cut out, kind of like an elevator, you know?
Yeah.
Or Bloomberg when you call and you're put on hold.
That's exactly what it's doing already.
That's what it's doing already.
Yes. Yes.
Are you public?
We are public, listed on the Copenhagen Stock Exchange.
Right. You want to list elsewhere? I mean, if you're the biggest in the world, you
we were
you
listed in
a
London Stock Exchange 10 years ago, but we kind of decided to focus.
What's wrong with the stock? What's going on?
It's about a different part of our company where we are actually selling it off, and we had a short delay in the sales process.
Right. Okay.
No big issue.
What's the next wave going to be in Bluetooth headsets?
Well, the next wave will probably be the convergence into you and I, the office workers, the facility of going into using your headset on the go, and then going directly into the office, and
yeah.
then continue to use your headset
mm-hmm.
for your VoIP or your fixed line application.
Right.
And then the stereo will boom as well.
Okay.
The stereo music will
I want
boom.
To show you something, by the way. Do you find you spend more time commuting than actually in the office? Are you taking the train? This kind of goes along with this Bluetooth thing we're talking to Christian about. A new a Japanese company may have your answer. Take a look at this. It's the Teleglass T3 F, and we're not talking Terminator 3 here. It's the world's first electric foldable, detachable TV screen, fits directly onto your glasses. $800 US. It includes the glasses, but not the lenses. It means you put an end to wasting valuable commuting time sleeping, and you can watch me and Kathy and Susan and Paul and the whole team here, or that, whatever that is. Don't do it while driving, though. It can be very, very dangerous. That's your consumer tip for this Tuesday, and that is Bloomberg Live. I'm Bernie Lowe. Kathy is here with Bloomberg Now in 3.
I'm Jaap van Ballengooien, chief engineer for Shell here in Brunei. For the last 2 years,